He was meant to be snake food. He had been abandoned not just once but twice because he had some problems with his eyes. I just wanted to take him home and give him a loving home. I'm Stine, and this is Klunk's story for GeoBeats. I've had several rats. Most of them have come to me in different ways because someone didn't want them anymore. They'd been in a situation that wasn't really good and nobody wanted to take care of them. When animals get abandoned, they get very sad and scared, and they're waiting for the humans to come and pick them up again. It broke my heart to see how scared and sad he was. He was pretty much completely blind. I took him home and we just had an instant connection. Just that first day, we cuddled for hours. He liked to get kissed on his little head. He liked to stay on my lap all the time and he would just sleep there and he wouldn't leave me. I think he stayed there because he was afraid that I would leave him too, because he had been abandoned before. They tried to put him together with another rat and it damaged his one eye. Also, because he didn't have any hair, a lot of things tended to get stuck in his eyes and block his tear canals. Rats are not solitary animals. I really wanted to integrate him with my group, but they thought he was kind of weird because he didn't have any hair. I think they kind of discriminated him because of that. I've never seen them be like that with other rats. You could see in their face that they thought he was disgusting. So the way he tried to interact with them is by slowly invading their personal space and just trying to mingle and lay down with them and cuddle and stuff. It took him months to become good friends. It was nice and really heartwarming to be able to give Klunk the group that he really deserved. Rats as pets are like cats and dogs, like the best parts of cats and dogs, because you come home and like dogs, they're really excited to see you and they will give you kisses and you can teach them tricks like dogs. They do see you as a part of their group. When you call their names, they can come running and they're not as disgusting as people think they are. They actually clean themselves close to as much as cats do, and you can also teach them to go to the litter tray. I just sit there with them all the time I'm home and I watch movies with them or I read. I also learn something from each of them. Okay. He loved me very much and I loved him too. He was very chill and calm. He was never angry with anyone. He just wanted to be friends with everyone. In the beginning of January 2021, the vet found that he had cancer in his bladder. So, of course, it wasn't fair to keep him here with me. I made the decision to put him to sleep. I will treasure all the memories we had. Even though they have such short lives, it's worth it to rescue them. I might be sad, but it won't hurt that badly for that long. And I can spend my time on new ones.